This is another example on how to remove epsilon productions from a grammar. As I said before, the start symbol is the only one that is allowed to derive to the empty word, because that is the only possibility that the language generated by the grammar contains the empty word. And in this case, it's not allowed that the start symbol appears on the in the right-hand side of any rule. And as you can see here, the S does indeed appear on the right-hand side. So this is not a correct grammar yet. And maybe, as I said before, if you do derivations, you may change the derivations when changing the grammar, but you don't want to change the generated language. So when we use this rule, let's say we have an A, and we use this rule to derive to B as B, then in one case the S can be the empty symbol, so we get something like this. And as before, you can just we can just skip this step and say that A derives to BB in one step. Let me close those brackets. So in this case, we don't need S to be an empty symbol, because we can just get the same functionality by directly going to this step. But if S does not go to not derive to the empty symbol but to the other things, you would this is another step from here. You would get something like this. That would be the first B from the right-hand side rule of A. Then you would have this part, and then you would have the second B. And in we can also do the same as before. So we say we just skip this step and make that A derives in one step to this. So in this case, we can take out this part of the rule. So we still have the same functionality with these two rules, and we don't have any S on any right-hand side rule anymore. And if S would go to any other strings, then we would have to replace them, or in this case as well, like I did here.